If you are experiencing EA AntiCheat has detected an unacceptable configuration error while playing FC 25, then you are at the right place. We have got some easy ways that you can use to fix this issue. Welcome back to Silicophilic, your go-to source for tech tips and fixes. Method 1. Check for any installed anti-cheat software. The first thing you need to do when you are getting EA AntiCheat has detected an unacceptable configuration error while playing FC 25 is make sure you don't have any other anti-cheat software installed on your PC. Other anti-cheat software may be installed with other games like CSGO or Valorant. So uninstall these anti-cheat software and then restart your PC. Check if the issue reappears. Method 2. Clean any temporary or junk file. Right-click on Start menu and select Task Manager. Look for any process related to FC25 or EA and right-click on them. Select the End Task option for each process. Now open the FC25 installation folder. For Steam users, open Steam and head to Library. Right-click on FC25 game and select the Manage option. Click on Browse Local Files and this should open the installation folder. Open the installer folder, double-click on the cleanup.exe file or cleanup file. Wait for it to finish. If you couldn't find the file, then move on to the next step. Method 3. Check the integrity of game files. Missing or corrupted game files can also cause issues like this. To verify the game files. Here is how you can verify the integrity of the game files from Steam platform. Head to the Steam library, right-click on the game and open its properties. Go to the Installed Files tab and click on the Verify Integrity of Game Files option. Wait till Steam verifies the game files and download the missing file or fix the corrupted game files. Once done, launch the game and check. Method 4. Reinstall the EA AntiCheat. The next thing you can do is reinstall the EA AntiCheat. Open the FC25 installation folder. For Steam users, open Steam Library and right-click on the game. Select the Manage option and click on Browse Local Files. Now open the installer folder and then open the EA AntiCheat folder. Right-click on the EA AntiCheat installer and run it. Select FC25 from the drop-down option and click on Uninstall. Once it's done, click on the Install option. After the installation finishes, start the game and check if the issue persists. Method 5. Launch the game from the EA app. Open the EA app on your computer. If you're not already logged in, enter your EA account credentials to sign in. Once you are logged in, go to the Library section. This is where all your purchased and installed games are listed. Look for FC25 in your library. You can use the search bar at the top if you have many games. Click on the games icon or title. This will open the games page. From there, click the play button to start the game. If it's your first time launching the game, you might need to follow some additional prompts such as agreeing to terms or downloading updates. Method 6. Add the game to the antivirus exclusion list. The next thing you can do is add the game to the antivirus exclusion list on your PC. If you have any third-party antivirus, then add the game to the whitelist or exclusion list. Those who are using Windows Defender, here is how you can do it. Type Windows Security in the search bar and select the top result. Select Virus and Threat Protection. Scroll down and click on Manage Ransomware Protection. Next, allow the app through Control Folder Access and select Yes. Next, click on Allow an app through Control Folder Access and confirm. Click on Add an allowed app option. Select Browse all apps. Browse to the FC25 installation folder and select the exe file. If you don't know where the installation folder is, then open Steam and click on Library. Right-click on FC25 and select Manage and then browse local files. Check the address of the installation folder and browse to it. After the game is added, run the game and see if the issue is fixed. If the issue persists, then try disabling the controlled folder access toggle from the ransomware protection settings. You can also disable firewall for the time being. Since it is always recommended not to disable firewalls and antivirus as your system is vulnerable to malicious threats without them, enable them soon after. Type Windows Defender Firewall in the Windows search box and select the top option. Click on Turn Windows Defender Firewall On or Off option. Click on the radio buttons for Turn Off Windows Defender Firewall Not Recommended options for both private and public network settings. Save the changes by clicking on OK. Method 7. Enable Secure Boot. The next thing you can do is enable Windows Secure Boot. So you can try this and see if this fixes the problem. Type system information on the start menu and open the top option. Check the secure boot state and see if it is on. If it is on, then move to the next solution. If it is off, then you will have to open the BIOS and enable it. BIOS settings are different for every motherboard type. Here we have shown how to enable it on the BIOS we have. The steps should be similar, so try to follow as shown. Now here is how to enable secure boot. Each PC has a different BIOS key. The general BIOS keys are F2, F10 or Dell. But they will differ as per the motherboard. If you don't know BIOS key, then check for the manufacturer's manual and keep it handy. Now follow the process given below to enable secure boot in Windows 11. You can also enter BIOS from Windows settings. Press Win plus I to enter settings. Then select system. Then select recovery. Next, click on the Restart Now button beside the Advanced Startup option. From the Advanced option, select Troubleshoot. Next, select Advanced Options and UEFI Firmware Settings and Restart. This will help you to enter BIOS or the UEFI settings. Then select Boot, System Configuration or Security option. This will depend upon your BIOS settings. Select the Secure Boot option. If you cannot find the Secure Boot option, click on the CSM support and disable the option. Then go to the extreme bottom and you will find the secure boot option. To enable the option, press the enter key. If you find the option has grayed out, then set the administrator or supervisor password. Make sure to keep a note of the administrator password so that you do not forget. You will need this administrator password whenever you boot into BIOS. Now you will be able to enable secure boot. Press the F10 button on your keyboard and press Enter. This will save the changes and help to exit the window. Boot into Windows 11 and press the Windows key. Enter System and select System Information from the options. From the System Summary tab, search for Secure Boot State. If you see it is on, you have successfully enabled the secure boot. Method 8. Contact EA Support. If the methods shown in this video could not fix the EA anti-cheat error while playing FC25, then you can reach out to EA Support for help. You can get in touch with live support through the official EA Help site, or you can reach out via X, formerly Twitter, or Facebook for help as well, if you prefer. And there you have it. The solutions to fix the EA anti-cheat has detected an unacceptable configuration error while playing FC25. We hope one of these methods have worked for you. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more tech tips and troubleshooting guides. Leave a comment and help others know which solution solved your problem. Thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next video.